was a fierce warrior. Turn to your neighbor and say, warrior.
Warrior.
Not a worrier. He was a fierce warrior, and when he went to battle, you know, the Lord used him mightily. The Lord really was walking with him. And you know, one thing that I've learned, out on the road, one of the most important things that I've learned on my travels in the last 4 years being out on the road is the most important thing. You need a covering. Everybody say a covering. You need some type of umbrella, because you know what? Like I was talking with my pastor, you know, when it rains, it pours, and sometimes the world is rough, you know, and you need some type of support system. You need people backing you up and saying, I got you. And that's, you know, one of the most important things. You need a covering, and not just that, but you need a Moses and a Joshua. I mean, you need someone to pour into you, and then you need to go off, and you need to pour into somebody else what you learn. Amen?
Yeah.
Amen. So turn to the book of Deuteronomy. Go ahead and turn to the book of Deuteronomy 3:22, and we're going to go ahead and begin. And before I do that, I'm going to kind of share some notes really quick. We all have a part to play in the kingdom of God. Amen?
Amen.
And although some mature quicker than others, we are all meant to get to the place where we realize our role in pushing the kingdom forward. And to help us realize our role in the kingdom, the Lord places people in our lives to help us realize our destiny. Everybody say destiny.
Destiny.
To help us tap into the fullness that God has for us. To help us tell the difference between a blessing and a curse. Because sometimes, even though sometimes we think we know it all, we really sometimes have a hard time telling between a blessing and a curse. Amen? Our leaders and our teachers help us young men and some of the older folk, you know, who are aged and up there in age, you might think they know it all. Our leaders and teachers help us young men and women understand what's important in life, like family and seeing our children grow up. Amen? But the truth is that one day God is going to call those leaders, those teachers, and our heroes on home to be with them. The truth is that there are certain battles that God won't allow our leaders to lead us in. There will come a season where we need to pick up our sword and shield and do what the great ones did before us. Amen?
Come on.
Amen.
I'm hearing you tonight. Come on now.
Come on.
Deuteronomy 3:22. And if you're there, let me hear an amen.
Amen.
Amen. And I'm going to go ahead and read it. And we're going to go ahead and talk about Moses. And then we're going to jump over to Joshua. And then if you know anything about Moses, Moses was also a fierce warrior. He was a prophet of God. Everybody say prophet.
Prophet of God.
Now, if you know anything, God used him. God used him against the oppression of the Egyptians, and then he used him in the wilderness, and then God led him to where he is, to where he was in the Bible in Deuteronomy 3:22. And this is Moses is forbidden to cross the Jordan. We're going to go ahead and begin. It says, this is what the word of God reads. Do not fear them, for it is the Lord your God who is fighting for you. Everybody say fighting for you.
Fighting for you.
23, then I pleaded with the Lord at the time for his favor, saying, O Lord God, you have only begun to show your servant your greatness and your mighty hand. For what God is there in heaven or on earth that can do such works and mighty acts as yours? I pray, let me go over and see the good land that is beyond the Jordan, the good hill country and Lebanon. 26, but the Lord would not listen to me. And the Lord said to me, enough, speak to me no longer about this matter. God said, you shall not cross this Jordan. Come on. You got to understand, Moses had did all this work. Moses was in the wilderness for about 40 years. And then God called him and he went back and he freed the Hebrews and he freed his people. And God performed all these miracles, signs, and wonders. And you got to understand. Those miracle signs and wonders, they took a lot of work. You know what I mean? They took a lot of labor, a lot of time. And then he was in the wilderness for 40 more years.
Come on.
And then the Lord drops the bomb on him. He says, you will not cross into the promised land. Ooh, come on. How are you going to react when the pastor tells you, you will not cross into the promised land? Or your leader says, you will not get this raise. Or your buddy says, you know, your boss says, you will not get this promotion. Come on, I know. Come on, somebody. How many would get into our flesh? Come on now.
Come on, Jesus.
Come on now. I know, that's a lot. Yeah, it's expensive. I know, I travel.
Yes.
But the Lord said, you will not cross into this Jordan, into the promised land, or the Lebanon. But 28 reads this, but command. Everybody say, but command.
But command.
Joshua.
Joshua.
The word of God says, but command Joshua and encourage and strengthen him, for he shall go across and lead this people. He will give them the land which you see as an inheritance. And now here we go. We have Joshua stepping up. The Bible says, God told Moses to go and ready young Joshua, because Moses was not going to be allowed to cross into the promised land. And so God had Moses prepare his young disciple. Amen?
Amen.
I'm going to go ahead and read some notes that I have really quick, and then I'm going to go ahead and move on. God is telling Moses he will not cross into the promised land. He will not be allowed to cross the Jordan River. He will not be a part of the conquering that is to take place on the other side of the Jordan River. Up to this point, Moses has done everything God has asked for him. Has anybody ever felt like that? Like,
yeah,
I've done everything that this Lord has asked for me. Come on.
Come on, truth it.
But now the Lord is telling him and giving him specific instructions. He will not cross into the promised land, but it is his responsibility to commission and ready young Joshua, his disciple. You follow me? You see what's happening? A passing is happening. Amen? God tells Moses, it is at the leadership of Joshua, your spiritual son, to lead these people to the land they were promised. Joshua will lead them into the fullness of what I have for them, says the Lord. And I believe, this is what I believe. I believe Joshua needed to lead them. I believe it needed to happen. I believe it was important for a new generation, a younger generation, to step up and take the lead. To step up and take the lead. I believe it was time for younger men and younger women of God to step boldly into the promised land. By their leaders, conquering everything that lay ahead of them, Moses could not hold their hands any longer. Joshua's generation was commissioned. It was time. Everybody say it's time. Hey, we're living in time. Like that. Like that. It's time. It's time, buddy. It's time. Your time. It's time. Deuteronomy 31, 1 through 8. We're going to go ahead and talk more about just the passing, and then now you can kind of see what's happening. Moses, all this work Moses had done. When you're there, let me hear an amen. You know, Moses had done all this work, and here you go. Now we have his spiritual son. You gotta understand, you know, the Bible said to ready him. When a leader is readying you, that means he's pouring out into you, and he's molding you, and he's helped shape you, and he's just giving you words of encouragement when you can't pay them bills. Come on, and you can't afford the gas in church. And that's what was happening with Moses. You guys following me? You guys with me?
Come on.
Deuteronomy 31, 1 through 8. Joshua succeeds Moses. And this is where it takes place. 31. So Moses went and spoke these words to all of Israel. Everybody say all of Israel. And that means everybody was there. Everybody was in attendance. All of Israel. Men, women, children, aunties, nanas, tatas, the taco ladies, everybody was in attendance. Everybody. The Bible says all of Israel. And he said to them, I am 120 years old today. I'm 120 years old today. Come on, somebody. I am no longer able to come in and go out as your spiritual and military leader. Come on, that's deep stuff. And the Lord has said to me, you shall not cross this Jordan. But how many remember that he wanted to? You know what I mean? He wanted to continue. It is the Lord your God who will cross ahead of you. He will destroy these nations before you, and you shall dispose of them. Joshua is the one who will go across before you, just as the Lord had said. 4. You know, I'm going to go ahead and jump down to 7. This is what the word of God tells us. Then Moses, everybody say, then Moses.
Then Moses.
Okay, here it goes. Here it happens. Then Moses called Joshua and said to him, in the sight of all the people of Israel, here's what happens. Be strong and courageous, for you will take these people into the land which the Lord has sworn to their fathers to give to them, and you will give it to them as their inheritance. How many know what the word inheritance means? You know, how many know that inheritance means it's like your birthright? Everybody say, birthright.
Birthright.
That means it belongs to you. That means nobody can take it. They can't cut the bloodline. They can't kill you. They can't try to steal it from you. That means what's on the other side of the river is your birthright. It belongs to you.
Come on.
And nobody can take it. Everybody reach out and grab it like that. Man. And pull it in.
Yes.
Right.
Amen.
I have some notes here. I'm just going to go ahead and read before I move on to Joshua 12:1 and 12:6. This is what the Bible did. Here's some notes. Here's some notes for you guys. You with me? Amen?
Amen.
Everybody say amen, amen.
Amen, amen.
You guys ready to go on tour, huh?
Amen, amen.
It is official. Here it is. It is official. The disciple has now become the leader in the presence of God and all of Israel. You with me? You follow me?
Amen.
Joshua has just been commissioned. He has just been given the spiritual and military responsibility to lead God's people. And although Moses tells his people he is no longer able to lead them, we need to understand it's not because of his old age. Everybody say, not because he was old.
Not because he was old.
It's not because he was an aged, older man of God. In Deuteronomy 33:7, the Word of God tells us that Moses died at 120 years old. Everybody say 120.
120.
Yet his eyes were not weak, nor his strength gone. Which tells us he could have kept leading these people. He could have kept leading them.
That's right.
His strength was still there, and his eyes were still there. But like all leaders in our lives, whether at work, at school, on the football team, in our communities, or in our church, there comes a season, everybody say season.
Season.
When our leaders or our spiritual fathers and mothers will recognize if we are ready and will pass the mantle.
Woo! Come on, Jesus! Talk to me, Lord.
You guys with me today?
Yes, Lord.
Everybody say amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, my God. Thank you for that email that just popped up and threw me off. Man, that's the thing about Apple. My pastor Jason's trying to get me on Apple. There comes a season when our leaders and our spiritual fathers and mothers will recognize if we are ready and will pass the mantle down to us. Everybody say down to us.
Down to us.
And will pass the weight of the responsibility that lays on the shoulders down to us and us as a people, a generation, need to be ready to receive it. We need to be ready to apply what we have learned. From the moment Moses was called to the moment he died, he was putting in work for God. And it was just simply his time to go home to be with the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
He had done enough in the eyes of God. Now, God wasn't trying to wait for somebody to step up. Young Joshua is ready. Everybody say, young Joshua?
Young Joshua
is ready.
Is ready.
And it's going to take young Joshua and the younger generation to cross this Jordan and to take their inheritance, to cross this valley and to take their birthright, to climb this mountain. And it's going to take young Joshua and the younger generation to break certain generational curses.
Come on, yes, Jesus.
The Bible says your birthright. Come on now.
Jesus.
Amen. Joshua 12:1. Amen. You can go ahead and turn there really quick. 12:1, Joshua 12:1 and 12:6. And so what we're seeing now is it's gonna so the mantle has just been passed down from the leader down to the disciple. And although he was 120 years old, the Bible says he can still do one of these. He was still like this, and he was still praising and still leading.
Yeah.
But how many know, like, there comes a time when enough is enough.
Yeah.
And it's important for others to step up. It's important for to stop goofing off and pay attention.
Come on,
Jesus.
You know what I mean?
Amen.
I mean, who was that in class? Like, you just kept talking,
come on.
You're not paying attention.
Come on, Jesus.
You gotta catch it. I heard Pastor Jesse say, you gotta catch it, man.
Amen.
Amen. I see one hand in the whole building go up. Amen. Joshua 12:1. You know what I mean? And so now we're gonna see you. Although Joshua, you know, he was ripe and he was ready, and man, he was just beating on his chest, and he was like running laps, like in his little church suit, like I'm doing right now, and he was ready to get it, and he was just like, come on with it, come on.
Yes, Lord,
and
yes.
He was ready. I mean, well, like, even young Joshua, the Bible tells us he got it. You follow me?
Come on.
And it was after that, the Bible says, after that generation, everybody say it like that, right away, sure. After that generation, there came a new generation, another generation to follow. And how we know it's our responsibility to prepare that generation, to prepare our little homies, to prepare our people, to prepare them, to pour into them.
Come on.
The most important thing that I learned in my travels, traveling all over the world, is that you need a covering, you need an umbrella, because when it rains, it pours, meaning when it's hard, man. And sometimes those concrete floors that I sleep on, man, it gets hard, man.
Come on.
It gets really hard. And sometimes being on the road 300 days out of the year, the knees start to buckle. I'm being honest. I mean, come on, church, I'm being honest. You know, when the knees start to buckle, and it gets hard. So the one thing that I've learned is that you need an umbrella, you need a covering, and that's what I've learned. And not just that, but you also need to allow someone to pour into you. And then you need to go off and take what you've learned and pour into somebody else.
Yes, amen.
Because everybody say opportunity.
Opportunity.
And soon their time will come. And we're going to be excited for them, amen?
That's right.
Joshua 12:1. This is what the Word of God tells us. You guys with me?
Amen.
You with me?
Amen.
Amen. And maybe if the pastor lets me, I'll do one song after. We'll see. We'll see. The kids got to go to school. Joshua 12:1 reads this. Now these are the kings. Let me see. Now these are the kings of the land whom the sons of Israel defeated. So here we read about the kings of all that Israel defeated. Now if you read the Bible, the list is near endless, but it does end. And whose land they possessed by the Jordan towards the east. And the Bible tells us about the areas that had been defeated by Moses. So Moses was a beast. He was a sick leader. He was a prophet of God. And Moses had conquered a little portion. And then it was time for him. It was just his time to go. And here we have, the Bible tells us that Joshua steps up. And if you read the Word of God, it'll explain to you exactly how many kings and how many kingdoms and how many nations and how many people and how many rulers that Joshua defeated.
Woo.
So his resume is pretty deep, just like his leader before him. That means, you know, that shows that he had some pretty good leadership leading him, right? Because Moses' resume was, man, his resume was stacked. It was nice.
Yeah.
And then Joshua came, and how many know that sometimes, you know, generations to follow, this is what I learned, sometimes generations to follow are sometimes more equipped than the previous generations. You know what I mean? And that's
something
I learned in my travels, and something that I just kind of picked up on, and something that I was taught. So Moses was a beast, but here you have Joshua, and the Bible tells us that Joshua conquered 31 nations. He conquered 31 nations. That's 31 kings. It says specifically kings in the Bible. But you got to understand, that was kingdoms.
Amen.
That was armies. That was territories. That was entire countries and entire regions that had been conquered by the hands of Joshua. And you got to understand, in a military strategic army, you have how many people think, you know, how many members are in the U.S. Army today? Think about it. Probably in the millions. Maybe even billions? No, not that much.
Maybe.
Maybe, who knows? You know, who really knows? But in the U.S. Army, you have just the numbers are endless of soldiers that we have. So you gotta understand, Joshua went up against just nations and kingdoms and rulers, and he conquered them all because the Bible says God went before him. You follow me?
Come on.
You follow me?
Amen.
Amen, amen.
Amen, amen.
Amen. And here it is. I'm gonna just kind of share this with you guys. Joshua 13:1. When Joshua had grown old, there it is right there. The Bible tells us that Joshua had grown old, right? Now, I'm not saying he was like, you know, he was like Moses, where his strength hadn't gone and his eyes were still there. But the Bible says right there that he had grown old. He got old on his army. The Lord said to him, "You are now." Now it's coming from the Lord's voice. It's coming from Him, the Lord Himself. You are now very old. That ain't towards anybody up in here. I ain't specifically talking to nobody. You are now very old, and there are still. Everybody say, "There are still."
There are still
very large.
Very large
areas.
Areas
of land.
Of land
to be taken over.
To be taken over. Over.
That's what it is right there. So now the Bible says that here we have Moses. You know, and Moses has Joshua, and Moses is this just military and spiritual leader. He's very strategic. God used him. He put to perform miracles. signs and wonders to free the Egyptians, forgive me, Lord, the Hebrews from the Egyptians' oppression. Amen? And then we come Joshua. And then here comes Joshua. But now even the Bible says that Joshua even got old. And then later, as you read on into the Bible, now here David comes along and sets it in order. But the Bible says even Joshua, the young disciple who led, the Bible says he led his people, the Israelites, from one side of the Jordan into the promised land on the far end of the Jordan. And he conquered 31 kings. But the Bible says that there are still large areas to be taken over. You hear me?
Amen.
I have some notes here. I'm just going to go ahead and read to you guys. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
As you go on to read it for yourself, you will see that when the Lord was getting ready to call Joshua home, there were still large areas that needed to be taken. And although he conquered 31 kingdoms, there was still so much work that needed to be done. Now, I want to encourage you not to get too comfortable wherever the Lord may have you, because there is always land that needs to be taken.
Come on.
There is always territory that needs to be developed.
Come on.
Now, jumping into the new covenant, we jump over into the new covenant, which is what? The New Testament, which is Jesus. There was always souls that need to be saved, and there was always people that need to be helped. And just like Moses, and then even on to Joshua, the Bible tells us that our leaders will someday pass the mantle. Everybody say, someday pass the mantle.
Someday pass the mantle.
And I want to encourage you, wherever the Lord may have you, though, I encourage you not to get too comfortable, man. Don't be kicking off your shoes. Don't be. Another thing that I've learned on the road is it is good. It's good to sometimes, to slow down a little vehicle and to get a little bite of del taco and then to smell the roses. Me and my wife, now that my wife is traveling with me, I stop and I enjoy just the mountains out in Arizona.
Come
or
on.
In North Dakota, we'll go ride horses. And the Bible says that's okay to smell the roses, but not to get too comfortable. You know what I mean? Because there is always land to be taken. There is always territory that needs to be developed, and there is always souls that need to be saved.
Amen. Amen.
And in the new covenant, the Bible tells us that that's the most important thing right there. You know what I mean?
That's right.
So there is always people that are going to be coming in through these doors that need to be saved.
That's right.
That need an encouraging word. Yeah. That are looking for some type of help because yes. They're about to end it.
Come on.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Right. So I want to encourage you. I want to encourage you to stay motivated. I want to encourage you to read your word. I want to encourage you to help your brother and your sister out, man. Because when it's time, everybody say, when it's time.
When it's time.
Man, I pray that you're ready and you run with it, man.
Come on.
Get that little opportunity, whether it's cleaning the little toilets or taking out the dog poo-poo or taking out the trash or whatever opportunity it is.
That's right.
Like Joshua, leading your people into another territory, I pray that you guys are ready. I pray that we as a people, as a kingdom of God are ready. I pray that we receive it and we run with it in the
Jesus.
Name of
Jesus. Come on, the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. You guys still not right there?
Amen. Yes, Lord.
Amen. Give the Lord a round of applause. Moses, right? Moses, one of the greatest men of all time. The Bible says that there was none like this man. The Bible says that he was a prophet and there was none like him. Moses didn't make it across to the other side because of the 40-year delay. Everybody say the 40-year delay.
The 40-year delay.
Open your Bible, read it. Because of his own people, his spiritual sons and his spiritual daughters, his people were complainers. They were crybabies. Moses had to hold their hands and rebuke them.
Come on.
And teach them and then love on them.
Thank you, Lord.
And lead them. And the Bible says, because of these people, you're not going to see the Lebanon. You're not going to cross the land. You know what I mean? You're not going to make it because they weren't ready. So I pray that you guys equip yourselves. I pray that you allow God to use you. Whether it's traveling the world or reaching the youth, or whether it's doing the taking out the dog poo poo. Amen.
Amen.
Today is actually the third year anniversary of me and Pastor Jesse rolling together. Me and Pastor Jesse.
Jesus.
Glory to God.